Well, good morning, Abundant Life Church. Oh, there you are, bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. Let's all stand right now. Let's give Jesus some praise in this house, because that's why we gathered here today, is to rejoice and lift up the mighty name of Jesus. Amen? Let him hear it. Hallelujah to the name of Jesus. Glory to your name, Lord. We worship you today. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you all for being here today. Of course, my name is Reverend Stephen Harden. I'm up here on behalf of our pastors, both Drs. Glenn and Carolyn Davis, as well as our associate pastors, Scott and Sandy Taylor. We just want to give you a big old howdy. Say good morning to you. Howdy right back at you. And maybe you're watching, you're not from Texas. We say howdy here. That's how we greet you. But if you are watching maybe for the very first time, you're going to notice a toll-free 877 number right about there at the bottom of the screen. You see it says toll-free 877. That number's been there, placed there just for you. Maybe you got a praise report or a prayer request. But most importantly, if you need to know Jesus as your Savior today, please don't hesitate. Call that toll-free number right there. We have prayer warriors standing by right now to take your call. Amen? Amen. Here at Abundant Life Church, we always like to start each service with the reading of a Holy Scripture. If you'll all notice the screens right now, let's all read that together, shall we? Psalms 145 and 3. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. Psalms 145 and 3. Amen. We should all know that verse by now by heart. Amen. So in case you didn't know God was great, we want you to know that here at Abundant Life Church, we absolutely believe that God is good all the time and all the time. Y'all already know it. Are y'all ready to worship this morning? Amen. Don't sound like you ready to get your worship on this morning and worship his mighty name? Well, let's get it on. Let's worship with the Abundant Life Praise Leaders.
Hallelujah. Welcome to the house of the Hallelujah. Lord today. Amen. Woo. Hallelujah. Is there joy in this house?
Thank you, Lord. Is there joy in this house? Hallelujah.
We worship the God who evermore will. Something new. You're not gonna
praise you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Come on. Oh, we thank you, Lord. Woo. Hear those dry bones. Hallelujah. Rattling in the presence of the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Every trial.
to me, he's so much more. He's not just my friend, he's my father, and he's my savior. And Jeannie, he's my healer.
Yes, yes.
He is so much more than saying he's a friend. He's inside of us, he saves us,
yes.
He quickens our mind whenever we may do something that we shouldn't. He quickens our mind when we need to do something that we're not. I praise the Lord for him accepting me back, for me reaching out to him, and he took me and held me in his arms.
Thank you, Jesus.
And I praise him. I so praise him. You're my future.
Yes, yes.
You're my hope. And you're the
I'm not afraid to
ever need? You know, there's a lot of times that we say, well, I need this and I need that. But the truth is that our needs are often our wants. But with God, He's all we ever need.
Yes, yes, yes.
Anything that you're in need of, He has plenty supply of.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You know, God, you know, I've been amazed recently, probably two months ago, God just impressed upon my wife's and I's heart to sow a seed into some people's lives. And we did that, and it's just been amazing how God turns things around and how God begins to bless through those things and those times and seasons. And that and it just seems like everywhere we have turned lately and everywhere that we have done something, God has done exceedingly and abundantly above all that we could have asked or thought of, all by sowing the seed that I believe in those moments. And so, you know, no matter what you're going through or what God is saying in your life, you know, always heed to those moments that when God is telling you to do something, even if it's an act of faith of giving out of your comfort zone and doing something that you wouldn't have normally done, God is doing something. He's setting you up for a blessing. He's setting you up for something that's so spectacular that you can't even begin to imagine or think about what God is beginning to do. And so I've just been amazed at what God is doing in this day, in this hour. I know that we're in a new season. I know that we're in a new season as the body of Christ. It doesn't matter when you turn the TV on what the news people say. It doesn't matter what Washington says. It doesn't matter what the naysayers say, because He's all that we need. He's all that we need, no matter what. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. Well, praise the Lord. You may be seated this morning in the house of the Lord. It's good to be here on this beautiful spring Sunday morning, and it's just good to see everybody here. And I guess everybody got the memo on blue today. I'm seeing a lot of blue today. I didn't get the memo, Pastor, but I like it. Amen. I should have worn my blue suit today. Amen. Amen. Well, it's good to have Sister Lorraine Tadlock home with us today, a.k.a. Latterraine. My son, Cameron, when he was real little, we used to all hang out, and he never could say Lorraine, but he said Latterraine, and every time he's called her that. So she's been Latterraine to my family for nearly 30 years almost, and we're so glad to have her here today, and missing Jerry and Chad today, and tell them we said hi, and we love them very much. Amen, amen. Well, just a few quick announcements today. We want to say thank you. We want to say happy birthday and happy anniversary to everybody that has birthdays and anniversaries in the month of May. In the month of May, I had to think about that. Happy anniversary to me. Our anniversary's in my wife. That's our anniversary this month. So happy anniversary. So, and for those that have anniversaries and birthdays, in all seriousness, happy anniversary and happy birthday. Also, don't forget prayer services here at 5:30 in the sanctuary every Sunday night. Also, our midweek services start at Wednesdays at 7 p.m. This Thursday is the National Day of Prayer, and we're praying for our nation, and we're believing God for a great turnaround in America. Amen. And the National Day of Prayer will be held at the Levon Baptist Church at 11 a.m. here in the Garland area. Pastor Abraham has been asked to be one of those that are praying, and so we are praying over the National Day Prayer here in Garland, for Garland and for our nation. Amen. Also, just a quick note for the Ladies of Life. The Ladies of Life had a great event last night, had a great turnout of painting and just a time of fellowship, and thank you all for who showed up for that. And then also, next Sunday is Mother's Day, and there is a hat contest for all of the ladies, not the guys.
So, you know, guys, don't wear your hats, but that there'll be a contest in both services for the best hat. She did ask me to remind everybody that if you attend both services, you can only qualify for one of those services if you win the prize. So no two-time champions in that service. You will be able to win one of those if you're able to win, and there's a gift for that. And so the one who has the best hat, and I will tell you, Mother Mary, she's got some of the greatest hats, so you're going to have to bring your A game. And so that's next Sunday, both in the 8:30 and the 10:30 services. Also, there'll be a ladies' breakfast May the 21st at 8 p.m. in the fellowship hall. Pastor Sandy will need a couple of ladies to help out with the breakfast that morning. It's going to be a great time of fellowship for the ladies. Be speaking on emotional health, and I know that'll be a great time for the ladies of life. Amen. Also, mark your calendars for the singles on May the 13th at 7 p.m. in the fellowship hall. There's going to be a movie night May the 13th at 7 p.m. in the fellowship hall. If you have any questions, you can see Sister Tiffany Linson. Sister Tiffany, wave your hand. Amen. We appreciate Sister Tiffany for the great job that she's doing. And also, I believe that they have a book that everybody has bought, and that money is due today. So you can see Sister Tiffany for what the cost of that book is, and turn in collections for that, and you can see her after service. Amen? Amen. If you stand this morning for our healing declaration, I do want to say thank you all who has been praying for me. I've had a number of eye infections. It seems like it's been one after the other, and black eye after black eye. And you know the old story says, you know, what do you tell a guy who's got a black eye? Nothing, because he's already been told once. So in my case, I've been told four times, and I don't seem to get the gist of it, according to my wife's, because she likes to take credit for giving me all of those. But no, in all seriousness, thank you all who have been praying for me for that. I'm believing that this is the last of them.
Amen.
And I'm believing that's something in the rearview mirror, and I'm moving forward. Amen. Amen. And with that, we're going to speak the healing declaration over our bodies. If you're believing God for healing in your body, or if you know somebody that you're standing and believing for healing in, then we're going to say this today, not just words on a piece of paper, but we're going to say this, we're going to believe it, we're going to come into an alignment with what the Word of God says, that by His stripes we were healed. And so today, we're just going to come into an agreement with that today through this declaration today. Amen? Amen. If you'll direct your attention to the screen this morning and repeat with me, I declare by the stripes of Jesus that I am healed. He took my sickness. He carried my pain. I believe it is the will of God for me to be healed. In the name of Jesus, I break the spirit of infirmity, sickness, and premature death off my body. I declare that none of these things exist in my Heavenly Father. I declare in the name of Jesus that every sickness, hidden disease, infections, or pain in my body was paid for at the cross, and I am healed today. Amen. Do you believe it today? Amen, amen, amen. And while you're still standing this morning, we're going to receive our tithe and offering today, and we're going to start off by declaring the Word of God over our tithe and finances, and just an opportunity to give back what rightfully belongs to Him. Amen? Amen. If you'll repeat with me, oh God, today we believe You for an open heaven, unlocked storehouses, miracles, visitations, and divine manifestations. We join our faith and trust in Your Word by returning the tithe and sowing seed offerings into Your kingdom. By doing so, we know that You have rebuked the devourer in our lives, rain down on us and water our seed in favor, blessings, and increase in the name of Jesus. Everybody said, amen. Amen. You can bring your tithe amen. And offering at this time.
Ooh, glory. Draw me close to You. Never let me go. Lay it all down again.
on, guys, sing it with me.
You are my desire.
And only.
No one else will do. Nothing else can take your place. To feel the warmth of your
just before Pastor comes this morning, and I want to say on the behalf of my wife and I want to say thank you to this church for your love, your generosity that you've shown, and your kindness that you've shown to my wife and I over the past several months. And words cannot express the prayers that you have prayed, the texts that you have sent, the phone calls, the cards, and just overall your friendship. And I pray, and my wife prays, that God bless you 100-fold for your generosity And I want to say from the both of us, thank you very much. Amen. Are you ready to hear the word of the Lord this morning?
Amen.
Amen. Everybody say, God bless Pastor Davis.
Hello, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
And what a great day. What a great day. Amen. Amen. And Pastor Karen, I also want to say thank you to this church for the generous love offering that you gave this past week for Pastor Scott and Pastor Sandy. And we also, again, want to say thank you to them both, for what a incredible job they are doing, and will do. We just appreciate them so much. And we during these past few months have been well fed by the word of the Lord. Promise you top notch preaching and worship, and just we love all of you so much, and thank you both. We'll never be able to show you our appreciation, but we want you to know that we do love you guys. Amen. Brother Scott mentioned about the four black eyes, and in the meeting on Friday night, we had a wonderful time with fellowship for our married couples. And after all the devotions and the food, there was a game that was played. It was kind of a unique game. And in my house, I'm not kind of the game. Sister said more of the game person. She grew up, her dad loves games. And she's normally used to winning. She likes to win. And anyway, so in this game, I decided I would play, so I was playing against her, of course, and the guys were playing against their wives. So anyway, I won twice in a row. And she came up, she goes, and so she came up, she said, "That's two." And reminding me of an old joke that we used to tell and hear, and said way back in the old Western days when they were settling the West and there was a shortage of women, that the guys would mail order brides, and they would order by mail a bride from back east, and these ladies would get on a stagecoach and head out, you know, to Kansas and Texas and all the way out over, you know, Wyoming, and become the wife of one of these farmers or ranchers. And so in the story, this guy goes to meet his wife, and they never met before, and he meets her and puts her on the wagon. They start home. Just as they got to the edge of town, a couple dogs come barking at the mule, and the old mule started rearing up, almost turned the wagon over. Guy got it stopped, and he got off the wagon, walked around, got that mule by the reins, and he said, "That's one. That's one." She looked at him, "Get back on the wagon," and they go just a few miles, and all of a sudden something noised inside, and that mule started going crazy again. Got it stopped, and he walked around, got him in the rain. He said, "That's two. That's two." She looked at him. She didn't say anything. Finally, I almost got home, and a covey of quails flew up. That mule just went crazy. Man got off the wagon, walked around, got that mule by the rein, and said, "That's three." He took out his pistol and just shot that mule right between the eyes, right there. And his wife, to be, said, "I cannot believe you shot that mule like that." He goes, "That's one." My wife said, "That's two." I said, "I'm not playing again." We had so much fun, and I don't know how many times in life over the years we looked at each other, something would happen, we'd hear about, "That's two." Amen. Praise God. Isn't it feel good in the Holy Ghost today? In the 9:30 class this morning, if you were there, you know what happened. But if you weren't there, I encourage you to watch the video. The glory of the Lord came down so strongly. Jeannie, you remember, you would know that, Ina. We could not even, it was more than I could express, more than I could express. And we were changed. We were changed in His presence. So it's only about 30 minutes maybe, but I'd encourage you to watch it. I think you'll be blessed by it. Amen. Sister Tadlock, I can't tell you how much that Sister Harris and I and this church love you and Brother Tadlock. And so good to have you here. So good to have you here. And the Tadlocks have been in ministry for many, many years, both in this church and then in other churches as well. And we are always honored to get to see them or be with them. And we love y'all. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Amen. Amen. Praise God. I want to read today from the book of Acts, chapter 28. This won't had a professor, one of my professors in Bible college used to say, in teaching us about ministry and preaching, he'd say, you know, if the people will help you, don't take near as long if they don't help you. So Sister Davis said, y'all help me, I can get through. Y'all can get to lunch a lot easier than if y'all make me carry this whole battle by myself, all right? All right, so when this is in the story of Paul and the shipwreck, and when they were escaped, then they knew that the island was called Melita. Now, you'll see a picture. This is modern-day Melita. It's today that is called the island of Malta. Malta, same island, different, known by different name. It's a beautiful island in the great Mediterranean. It's 155 miles south of Italy coast. Sister Davis and I have had the opportunity to cruise through the Greek Isles, not this one, but three or four, including the Isle of Patmos, where John the Revelator received the book of Revelation. But when they escaped from this storm, it was the biggest storm of Paul's life. This is where they escaped. Now, it didn't look like that then, but that's where they escaped. And the barbarous people showed us no little kindness, for they kindled a fire and received us, everyone, because of the present rain and because of the cold. And when Paul had gathered a bundle of sticks and laid them into fire, there came a viper out of the heat and fastened on his hand. And when the barbarians saw the venomous beast hang on his hand, they said among themselves, no doubt, this man is a murderer, whom even though he has escaped the sea, yet vengeance suffereth him not to live. And he shook off the beast. Everybody say, shook off. He shook off the beast into the fire and felt no harm. Howbeit, they looked, when he should have swollen or fallen down dead suddenly. But after they had looked for a great while and there was no harm came to him, they changed their minds and said, now he is a god. He is a god. I want to preach about shake it off. Victory is here. Shake it off. Victory is here. Shake it off. Victory is here. Amen. And today, in just a few moments, we're going to have a victory march, an old-fashioned victory march in this house. And we're going to declare by doing so that anything that has been hanging on, whether it was to you, me, the body of, we're going to have a collective shake. The church is going to shake today. We're going to shake it off. That's a big shake. Woo! Glory to God. Hallelujah. So shake it off, because we know the victory is here. Now, we have come through the biggest storm. Brother Gentry, I've been in church all my life. You've been in and around church all your life. We've never seen anything like what we've seen these last 3 or 4 years. Not in the body of Christ, not in the world, not in our politics, not in the condition of mankind. This has been the most difficult passing, the most difficult time we've ever experienced. We've come through a massive storm. Yes, it's not been easy. It's not been easy on your family. It's not been easy on the body of Christ. It's not been easy. There are some churches that shut down because not enough people came back to hold the doors open. But could I just tell you today that the storm that we've been through is coming to an end. And there is a moment in time that we need to change how we think and what we think. Amen. And stand back up and reach up into the glory of God and bring down the power and the glory of the Holy Ghost. One more time. One more time. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Because we've come out of this storm. We're coming through this. It might have took some time. It took its toll for sure. But we're coming out. And we're coming out with victory. I said we're coming out with victory. Hallelujah. Praise God. Now Paul had come through the biggest storm of his life. The biggest storm of his life. And it was time now for something to happen that was going to change everything that he had gone through. Hallelujah. Remember when he was on board the ship, there was an angel of the Lord who stood by him and gave him a word. This ship might crash, but you're not going to lose your life, and every person who sails with you is going to make it. Next slide, please. Paul had come through the worst and the biggest storm of his life. But still, you can see the slide I've chosen today shows the storm, and yet the sun is coming down. That's the picture where we are right now. We can still see the storm. It's moving away, but we see the bright sun shine. I'm telling you, something's about to change in the body of Christ. Something's about to change in the house of God, and something's about to change in America. Amen. Because God is about to thunder from heaven. God is about to thunder from heaven, and the glory of God is coming down. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. So Paul is saved from the storm. God is saved from the storm because the same word that God gave to the Apostle Paul came true. Just like God's word to us is coming true. Next slide. Here in North Texas, even after the big thunderstorms have passed, we know there can still be lingering smaller storms. So I want to tell you something. No matter what you see or hear, things have changed. Something has happened in the Holy Ghost. The prophetic word is coming to pass. The glory of God shall be revealed. We stood in a service this morning that we could hardly stand up, hardly move, and the glory of the Lord was so strong in that 9:30 class. I'm telling you, I saw something, amen, and I felt something, and I sensed something that I hadn't done, hadn't seen or sensed in a very long time, and maybe not ever. So I'm telling you, we need to get ready to shake ourselves. We need to get ready to shake ourselves. Now, you know, everybody worships a little bit different. Everybody sings a little bit different. Everybody, you know, you react to the Spirit a little bit different. Some people are very emotional and excitable, and you react a different way. Some people say, well, you know, all mine's on the inside. Could I just tell you that if you're one of those kind of people, if somebody threw a snake on you, I think you'd take off. Woo! You would forget I'm not the emotional kind. You would forget I'm the quiet kind of guy. I'm the quiet kind of girl. No, no, no. If that snake was on you, you'd be getting that thing off of you. Hallelujah. Amen. Whatever, I want to tell you that whatever has tried to hold on to us coming out of this storm, it's got to go. I said, it's got to go. Whatever it may be. If it's just a little fear, a little doubt, whatever it is, it's got to go. Praise God. And it will go. Praise God. So when it comes, what comes out of the storm must be shaken off. The first thing that Paul does is start shaking that thing. He didn't pet it. He didn't hold on to it. He didn't make excuses for it. He didn't say, well, this is how I am. This is what I am. This is how I am. No. He said, you know what? This is going. It's not a part of me. It's not a part of my life. It's not a part of my spiritual future. And if it's not a part of my spiritual future, it's got to go. Hallelujah. So we know that victory is here. Victory is here. Praise God. So what comes out of our storm? Fear, doubt, discouragement. This is how we sometimes look coming out of the storm. I need a slide. There it is. There we are. That's how we look coming out of our storms. Confused, discouraged, feel hopeless, doubt. Here I am. Paul said, this can't stay. This can't stay. It's going. It's going. You see, how did Paul shake the viper off? Did he just go, well, I need to get rid of this snake? Because, see, this snake didn't just bite him. This snake was holding on to him. Huh. This snake was holding on to him. I guess some people shake a little. Some people shake a little. Some people shake a little. Well, I'll take this whole lot of shaking. There was a song written years ago, Jerry Lee Lewis. Whole lot of shake. I believe there's a whole lot of shaking going on. Well, I know that song was talking about dancing, but I'm going to tell you right now, Paul said everything that can be shaken will be shaken, that which may remain will remain to the glory of God. So my word to the churches and to the nation, there's a whole lot of shaking going on. And while this shaking is going on, some things are going to be falling off of America. Some things are going to be falling off of our government. Some things are going to be falling off of the body of Christ. Some things are going to be falling off of your house and your home and your family and your life. Hallelujah. So some people shake a little. Some people shake a little. Woo! Just a little shake. A little shake. And some people shake a lot. I guess it all depends on what you get. What's on you today? And how much of it you got on you? Our dolls can show us how to shake. Amen. Our dolls can show us how to shake. Amen. So remember, no fear, no discouragement, no pain, none of these things belong in our lives. So here's how we shake off these vipers. Number one, you got to realize there's a hindrance. Later, Paul's going to tell us, lay aside everything that hinders you. Everything that hinders you and that thing that so easily besets you. So, realize this thing is a hindrance. It's holding me back. Number two, turn up the heat. Do you know where that snake came from? It came out of the fire. Could I just tell you right now, snakes don't like fire. Unbelief doesn't like fire. Fear doesn't like fire. Amen. Sickness, affliction doesn't like the fire of God. Amen. 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 When this thing, he shook it back off. He didn't shake it off on the ground. He didn't shake it. He shook it back off in the fire. I'm sending this thing back where it came from. Hallelujah. This is going back where it came from. Amen. Return. Come on. Some of us need to take some of the mail you've been getting from the devil and just write, return to sender. Return to sender. This mail not wanted. Or refused. Don't open it up first. Just write refused on it. Because if you open it up and read it, you've done something's already holding on to you. We're about to shake as a church here today. We did it in the 8:30 service. We're going to do it here in just a moment. Pray. I think that Paul began to, when he was gathering those sticks, we can. Prayer, worship, and praise. Don't be affected by criticism or by praise. You can be criticized for a lot of things. We've heard it all. Don't let it affect you. Don't let it change you. The same as you need to be dead to praise as well. Because the people who praise you one minute can curse you the next minute. The people that thought Paul was a murderer one minute worshiped him as a god the next minute. If he'd have given in to the worship, he'd have been in trouble. He'd have given in to the discouragement. You can't listen to that. Here's what he did. He tells us what to do with anything that's trying to hold on to us. Shake it off. Shake it off today. Hallelujah. Praise God. So here it is. Find somebody to bless. After Paul was delivered from that thing, he went out and there was a revival on the island. People got healed. People got saved. The gospel was preached. The glory of God came. Hallelujah. So I'm encouraging you to shake it off today. We need to clap our hands. We need to shout aloud. We need to move. Listen, you say, well, I'm just so accustomed to things being like they are. No, not anymore. Amen. Today is the beginning of a new day for America. Today is the beginning of a new day for your family, for your children, for your grandchildren, for the church of the living God. This is a new day. This is a new day. We need to shout with victory. Hallelujah. Woo! Glory to God. I wish I had some firecrackers. Amen. I'm having trouble with my microphone. Hallelujah. We need to shout, leap for joy. Come on. My daddy used to tell the church when they got ready to have a shouting service, and somebody said, well, Pastor, I don't feel like shouting. He said, well, I didn't ask you if you felt like shouting. He said, you shout for joy. You shout to get it. If you don't have any joy, he said, you're the one that needs to shout the most. He said, the people have no joy, have no victory, have no glory. There's the one that needs to get out and shout. Others just think, well, I can't shout unless the Spirit moves on me. Well, did the last time the Spirit move on you, did you shout? Hallelujah. I'm meddling right now. Huh? Here's what Paul said later, Hebrews 12:1. Wherefore, seeing that we are also compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside or shake off. Lay aside that shake off right there. Let's shake it off. Every weight. There's some weights that we have brought out of this storm that we didn't intend to. There's some mindsets. I said, there's some mindsets that we've brought out of this storm that we didn't intend to bring out. There's thought patterns that was developed. Our ability to believe God for greatness and that God is a God of increase and not decrease. All that has tried to hold on to us. Hey, amen. If you need to lift your hands, somebody said, my hands feel like they weigh a ton. Of course. We're so weighted down. It's not that we intended to. It's not that we want to. It's just that coming out of the storm, Paul never, listen, he was shouting happy getting off of that ship, making to that land. The last thing he expected was a snake to latch on to him. But he wasn't going to let that snake stop him. The Bible said he shook it off. He shook it off. There's some things, Sister Ann, you just got to shake off. There's just some things in your life that you just got to say, you know what? This is not staying. This is not staying. Hallelujah. This is not staying. Today, Abundant Life Church is going to shake off some things that we need to shake off. Not just for us, but we're going to do it for the world. We're going to do it on behalf of the city of Garland. I said in the 8:30 or 9:30 class, as the glory of God was falling, I said, I'm praying that the city of Garland gets to be known as the city of revival. Anybody thinks about Garland or the Metroplex or Rowlett or this whole area, that they think about the glory. Oh, my God, that's where the glory is falling. That's where the power of God is falling. That whole area has become a city of revival. Why? So today, we're going to stand up here in just a few moments, and if you're able to walk, if you can't walk or march, I mean, please don't feel badly. Just stay seated. And you can just clap your hand, you can raise your hand. I just want you to do something that you normally don't do. If you just have to do this, do something that you normally don't do. That, man, you're helping me preach, by God. Oh, glory to God. So we can shake it off. Lay aside every weight and the sin that so easily does this beset us. And let us run. We're running. Hallowed with patience the race that is set before us. Looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. There needs to be a whole lot of shaking going on. Hallelujah. A whole lot of shaking. We're looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Can you say praise God? Hallelujah. So I'm praying for you. I'm praying for me. I'm praying for this church. That whatever we need to collectively and individually need to move out of. Mindsets, fear, depression, the lies that the devil told you about yourself, about your family, about your finances, about your marriage, about your home. Whatever lies he's tried to remember, he's a liar. He's a liar. You can't trust him. You can't trust him. So I said, what if what the devil tells me doesn't come true? Well, it's not going to. My daddy used to tell a story, and I'm getting ready to ask the musicians to come. My daddy used to tell a story when I was just a young kid in his church. He said there was a cold winter day, frost on the ground. Cold winter day, frost on the ground. A man encountered a rattlesnake. He was cold and nearly frozen. Just point of death. And in my daddy's story, the rattlesnake said to the man, he said, please, save me, pick me up. I'm dying. Help me. I promise I won't bite you. Just help me because I'm not going to be able to live. And in the story, the man picks up the snake and puts him in the bag that he's carrying on his shoulder and by his coat pocket and started on his way, and after a while, the heat from the man's body began to warm up the snake. In just a few minutes, the snake was uncoiled and out, about to bite the man. And the man said to the snake, you told me that you wouldn't bite me. And the snake said to the man, you knew I was a snake when you picked me up. You knew I was a snake when you picked me up. There's some things that we know better to pick up. I said, there's some things that we know better to pick up. Because they'll come back to bite you over and over again. But today we're going to march. Because victory shall be mine. Let's all stand now. Those of you that can do this, I'm coming down here right now, and I'm going to start this. I was going to bring my flat top guitar, but I was afraid I couldn't keep the rhythm and march at the same time. So what we're going to do, if you believe, You said, Pastor, I don't even know if I feel like doing this. I'm just asking us by faith. This is not just for us. This is for our family. I'm marching for Linda's family, my sister who's been with the Lord in heaven. I'm marching for my family. I'm marching for Sister Davis's family. I'm marching for this community. Yes, come on. I'm marching for the city of Garland. Yes, I said, I'm marching for the city of Garland. Rowlett, praise God. All the Roy City, all the Metroplex. We're marching for Jesus today to be revealed. Amen. And we're marching for deliverance. Yes. If there's anything in your heart, or your life that needs to be laid down today, let's lay it down right now. Victory, victory. If you want to do that, let's go.
Victory, victory shall be mine.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, victory, victory shall be mine.
Glory.
If I hold my peace, let the Lord fight my battle. Victory, victory shall be mine. Oh, victory, victory shall be mine.
Let the Lord fight my battle. Victory, victory shall be mine.
anywhere yet, musician. Don't go anywhere yet. Now, here's what I want you to believe. That if you did this by faith, that you should expect something this week to be turning loose.
Amen.
In your family, in your body, in your mind.
That's right.
Amen. With your children.
Yes. Yes.
With your relationships.
Yes.
With your finances. In your realm of influence,
yes,
where you are able to reach out and touch lives, something changed today.
Amen.
Because we dared to shake it off. Hallelujah. I got news for this old feeling coming out of this storm. That feeling is not going to stay. That mindset's going. Hallelujah. 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 So while we sing one more time, we're going to sing, and Pastor Scott's going to come and close the service today. Let's worship the Lord. Victory. Oh, baby.
Victory, victory shall be mine. Victory, victory shall be mine. If I hold my peace, let the Lord fight my battles. Victory, victory shall be mine. Victory, victory shall be mine. Victory, victory shall be mine. If I hold my peace, let the Lord fight my battles. Victory, victory shall be mine.
Victory, victory shall be mine.
Victory shall be mine.
Victory, victory shall be mine. If I hold my peace, let the Lord fight my battles. Victory, victory shall be mine.
Amen. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Lord. You know, some years ago, this pastor preached this. It kind of brought it back to my memory. Some years ago, I was working over here in Garland, and we had these, you know, worked around some of these guys that are just, you know, real cut-ups. And as a matter of fact, one of the guys, Johnny, made it well known he didn't like snakes. This is for you, Sister Tiffany. Don't leave. Sister Tiffany will leave if you preach on snakes, Pastor. But Johnny let everybody know that he didn't like snakes. Well, Big Randy took this to heart. He's like, okay, he doesn't like snakes. Randy went out in the field behind his house and killed a snake about that long. So he brought it to work just to mess with Johnny. And he gets to work, and he reaches up there, and he throws that snake right on Johnny's shoulder. And Johnny does the Pentecostal helicopter, if you know what that is. You know, I'm surprised he didn't wind up. He was a real gentle guy, but boy, when that snake was there, he began to start shaking and running. I'm surprised he didn't hit walls or whatever it was, but he went to start fighting with himself. And all through that day, Randy tormented him with that snake, laid it everywhere he could possibly lay it. But the point being is that the devil may try to torment you, but you got to keep shaking that thing off, keep moving. If you got to do a Pentecostal helicopter dance to get free or whatever it is, you need to do that. Amen. Amen. Shake some things off. And I agree with what Pastor says, that you should expect a release this week. Amen. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
Well,
amen.
Praise the Lord. Let's bow our heads this morning. Dear most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you today. We thank you for the worship.
Hallelujah.
We thank you for the word. And most of all,
yes,
we thank you for your presence
thank
today,
you, Lord.
Lord, we thank you for what you're doing in this hour, O God. Lord, that there is a turning, O God, in this nation, O God. Lord, turning men and women's heart back to you, God. We thank you, Father, for the revival, the harvest that's before us. Lord, we just thank you today. Lord, I pray that you'll be the words upon our lips this week as we go out into a dark world, Lord, that we'll be a beacon of light, O God, that we'll be able to speak into the hearts and lives of those that would not otherwise hear it, Lord. use us, oh God, this week to bring forth the gospel, Lord, and to bring in the harvest. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen. Shake hands. And be
thank you so much for watching the service today. We're so glad that you were with us. We trust that the word of God and the praise and worship was a blessing to you. Amen. You can worship with us in person every Sunday right here at 8:30, 9:30, and 10:30. Don't forget, we're located at 1717 Castle Drive here in Garland, Texas. You can join us Wednesday night through streaming with our Wednesday night service at 7 p.m. We're praying for you. If you're part of our extended family, thank you so much for loving us, praying for us, and supporting us. Thank you for the tithe and the offering and the gifts that make possible this ministry, reaching not only Garland, but around the world. Amen. Praise God. If you're a first-time guest today, welcome, and we hope that you will come back. Before we go, if there's anybody that while we were preaching and while the service was going on that you entertained the thought of getting closer to God, giving your heart to the Lord, coming back to God, amen, just receiving Christ for the first time, then we pray right now that you'll allow us to take that moment with you. It's a simple prayer. It's something like this. Mean it with your heart. Believe it. Trust God's word. And just say, Dear Lord Jesus, forgive me of all my sins. I repent today. And I accept the blood of Jesus as full payment for my sin. Fill me with your Holy Spirit. Change my life. And I'll serve you for the very rest of my life. Amen. If you prayed that prayer, call somebody, better yet, call us, and let us help you walk through those next steps of water baptism, receiving the baptism of the Holy Ghost, and being blessed in the name of the Lord. Don't forget, we'll see you the same time next Sunday.